Kawhi Leonard, Rob, just signed the 4-year, no surprise, we knew he was going to stay with the Clippers.
Right.
But he just signed a couple days ago for 4 years, $176 million. Now, the interesting thing with Kawhi, Rob, is he left some money on the table. I mean, he's obviously still generational wealth, but there are several ways. He got the max, but there are several ways he could have done it where he could have gotten even more money. You know, so, he could have signed like a 1-year deal or a 2-year deal with a player option after next season and then signed for 5 years, $235 million. He could have opted into his contract and not become a free agent this summer and then signed like 4 years, 180-something million. So it was weird. I mean, again, obviously he doesn't have to worry about money again for the rest of his life.
You know why I'm going to say it's not weird, Chris? Coming off another injury, you know, like you keep betting on yourself. I think, like, I would want to secure that money for sure. At this point, do you know what I mean?
Like, I do.
If he had another injury, say he comes back and he's not right or whatever, like, he's going to get paid. He's going to miss most of the season, could miss the whole year. And then you'd have to reestablish yourself next year. You know what I'm saying?
Well, what it may do, Rob, and I'll say this, I don't expect to see Kawhi next year. And, you know, that's just my opinion. I mean,
you're not a doctor. You haven't examined him, right?
But I think it makes it more likely that he does come back. That he's the fact that he's already signed a long-term deal. Because had he done the short deal, let's say he did a 1-1 and or a 1-year deal, he's not going to want to come back in April or May and risk being rusty and not looking good. You know what I mean? And you say he came back and just didn't look like himself. And now you want them to give you the long-term max deal. You know what I mean? So maybe he would have said, you know what, I'm not even risking it. Whereas now he's got his money, he's set. So, you know, he can come back and not worry about if I don't look quite 100%. You know what I mean?
I think it makes total sense financially. You know what I mean? Like coming into an off season where there's some doubt. I mean, you expect to come back, but you don't know. Nobody knows.
So let me throw this at you. 4-year deal. So, over the next 4 years, do you think he leads the Clippers to a championship?
I do. And I know a lot of people are going to say, nah, they're not going to win. Brooklyn's there and LeBron and Utah and the Phoenix Suns and all that. We just saw Giannis win a championship. Because Kevin Durant has a big foot. Because, a couple of players in the West got nicked up, got you know, so it opened the door. Can they do it? We just saw them go to the Western Conference Finals without them. They were down 2-0 to Utah. That was the number one seed in the West. And somehow they were able to get through that. They went through 6 games through the Suns. If Paul George hits a free throw or two, Chris, who knows how that series turns out? So they're there. We found out that Ty Lue is a damn good coach. There's a lot of things I like. Reggie Jackson came of age. There was a lot of Ibaka comes back right after surgery, Chris. There's a lot of things that are going on. A window can open up for the Clippers. It's not impossible because we saw it happen. So I think that they do win one championship at least, one, during his 4 years with the Clippers coming up.
The window's definitely open. I mean, you'd be an idiot to say the window's not open, you know, once he gets back. That said, I don't think they'll win one. And here's why I say that. One, again, I'm not expecting to see him next year because that injury supposedly is 9 to 12-month rehabilitation. 9 months would get him back around mid-April, which is right when the playoffs start. So he won't play the regular season at least. And I think, Rob, I think they'll make the playoffs. But it's not a guarantee without Kawhi because the West, you know, is a pretty deep conference. But I do think they get in. But I just think I don't think he'll come back because he's overly cautious. In addition to just the timetable, he's a guy that historically has just been, you know, I got to be 100% before I'm going out there. And I heard stories about him like that when he was in San Antonio, before he became a star. He just is that guy that's, look, he's cautious about his body. And so I don't think he'll play next year. So if I take away next year, he's going to be 31 when the next season starts, 2022 season. And, Rob, it will have been 5 years at that point since he played more than 60 games in a regular season. And I don't think he's going to get healthier than he's been as a younger player. So there's going to be load management. I'm sure there's going to be big-time load management. And I just think that he's not going to be a better player. I think he'll be really good. I still think he'll be a top 10 player. And he may be exactly what he is now, like what he was when he got hurt, which is one of the best players in the world. But I don't think he'll be better. And as he is now, he lost the 3-1 lead to Denver last year. And this year, when Kawhi was there, they were 2-2 with Utah in the second round. A pretty good Utah team, but not world beaters. And then they went on, of course, and won the series without him. But I'm just saying, like, they haven't been a spectacular team with him yet.
But and if so, he was healthy, yeah, do you think they would have got to the finals if he was healthy?
I think they would have. But, okay. You know, I think
no, I'm
that.
Just asking.
But, yeah, I do. I think they would have been better than Phoenix. And I think they would have had a shot against Milwaukee. But by the time he gets back, Luka's coming. I mean, Luka's giving him all he wants now.
Yeah, but right. let him get out of the first round for no, crowning
still,
Luka.
Rob, he's taking by himself. He's taking the Clippers to 6, and he's taking the Clippers to 7. I get it. He hadn't won. But he's giving Kawhi and Paul George fits, and he's only going to get better. Giannis, who knows what type of swag this championship's going to give him in the Bucks, so they're not going anywhere. Brooklyn's about to sign, it looks like it, Kyrie and Harden for the long haul. They already got Durant signed up for the long haul, so they ain't going nowhere. And that's not even to mention the Lakers and the Suns. And I mean, so I look, like you said, there's no doubt they're contenders. And the window is open. Like, you can't write them
off. I just look at Milwaukee winning. When Giannis signed in back in Milwaukee, people swore up and down he made a grave mistake. He'll never win a title. That was dumb. Why would you do that? And you know, things worked in his favor, Chris, but he won. He won a championship.
No doubt.
And so that's why I believe that there's always a will, there's a way. I don't think that we could sit here and map out and say who's going to win the next four championships. We don't know. We don't.